What's up, tech fans? Sometimes big things do come in small packages. Today's video is brought to you and sponsored by the OBSBot Tiny. That's this little guy in my hand. It's a smart AI-enabled webcam, shoots at 1080p at 30 frames per second, works in low light, works off hand gestures. It's $199, but I'm gonna have a coupon code for you guys for 30% off. So let's just jump in and let's see what the OBSBot's all about. So first off, let's take a look at what comes inside the box. Inside the box, you get the camera itself, a little mounting magnet, and you also get the power cable itself, which is a USB cable, and you get the manual. Beyond that, that's pretty much all you need. Now, the OBSBot is a smart AI webcam, and it's really kind of interesting the way that it works, because it works in a few different ways. If you're just installing it, all you need to really do is just plug it in. It is a plug and play product. But if you want to have more advanced features, I would really advise installing the OBSBot app, because here you guys can see you can change all kinds of things. You've got three different modes: standard, head mode, and then sport mode. Got three different modes, right? All kind of cool. Now, what they really do is this: how the camera is controlled. So using the OBSBot right out of the box is very easy. You simply plug it into your USB port. After that, the camera is controlled by hand gestures. Now, the OBSBot Tiny, it works with simple hand gestures to control the camera. And it's really, really easy to do. There are only really two different hand gestures. The first one is just holding your hand up with all your fingers. The camera will flicker blue three times and then lock into you, and then it will follow you around wherever you go, like so. It's kind of slow right now and squeaky, but then it'll follow me over here. If I go over here, it'll follow me over here. It'll pretty much follow me anywhere I go. Now, there's also a zoom feature on the camera, and to use the zoom feature, you use the L motion. Then you can zoom in, and then you can zoom back out. Once it locks again, you can zoom back out. Very easy to use. Now, there is no adjustment on the camera, but it does lock into the subject and keep them pretty clear most of the time. In a low lit room like this, let me go and turn the light off. I'll let you guys see what it looks like with no light. Bear with me. So here's with no light whatsoever, and you can see there's not even that big of a difference. This is with absolutely no light in the room except for a little bit of ambient light behind me. So in this type of environment, it works pretty good. And it's really easy. Two simple hand gestures and you're good to go. And you guys can see it actually looks pretty clear. Right now it's recording at 30 frames per second at 1080p. So that's pretty much the standard across the internet right now. So there you have it. Simple hand gestures. It looks good. You guys can hear the microphone. The microphone doesn't sound bad whatsoever. Up to 2 meters away. That's totally, I think, you know, good enough for anybody. What do you guys think?
And what's really cool is that even if there were multiple people in the room while you're using the OBSBot, it will stay locked on to you. Now, like I said, there are actually three different modes to choose from inside of their software package. They have what's called headroom mode, and what this does is this allows you to stand up or move around, and your head will always stay inside of the shot.
So here now we're going to be taking a look at the OBSBot in headroom mode. As you guys see, as soon as it saw me, it locked back onto me. I am the only person here. And as I walk up to it, you guys can hear the difference in the microphone. And you can see it's tracking me. Now, like I said, as I move away, the camera follows me. I go over here. The camera continues to follow me. Pretty much just keeps your head in the shot at all times. Let's see what happens if I like bend down a little bit. Does it follow me down too? Yeah, it even follows me down.
Right now, I'm in my wheelchair, so I really can't jump around and show you guys a lot of crazy stuff, but in sport mode, if you were teaching a class like gymnastics or something like that, it would stay locked onto you the entire time. I'm mainly, like I said before, going to be using the headshot one because that's best for me. I'm usually just sitting down and I want it to lock on to my head. So that's what I'm gonna be doing the most. But I really do like the product. Now, not everybody is going to use all of the camera's features because actually not only is it your webcam, there's also a microphone that's built in. And from up to 2 meters, it'll totally pick up your voice and everything else. And it's a pretty decent microphone, as you guys can see. It actually works pretty decently. It's not the greatest microphone in the world, but if you're just doing web meetings and standard stuff like that, or you're just trying to get online really, really quick and do something, it's very easy. Now, one thing I really want to talk about, which I thought was really crazy, is I plugged the camera in. And then when I was first trying to figure out what was the best way to record something, whether I wanted to really use, you know, QuickTime or could I use Logic, I was looking around doing something. As soon as I opened up YouTube, as soon as it opened up, it was like, hey, would you like to go live? So I was up, honestly, and running live on YouTube within seconds of plugging it in. Now, this is before I even figured out anything else about the camera. I mean, that to me was pretty impressive. I could literally put a thing on YouTube saying, hey, I'm gonna be live in five seconds from now explaining something that just came out, and I could be up and live with the OBSBot within seconds. And that was really pretty cool. If you're a professional person who's doing vlogging and stuff like that and working from home, you guys know that today everybody's almost working from home. That's how it is. So, you know, whether you use Zoom meetings or something else, this camera will work with all of them. Now, one thing to take note, when you probably first hook the camera up to your computer, if you already have an internally built computer like a Mac or something like that, you're going to want to turn that camera off. And if you're using QuickTime, make sure that in the options that you select the OBSBot Tiny, otherwise it's going to be using the default camera that it sees on your computer. But beyond that, it is really simple. You plug it in and you start going. Really, I thought was kind of trippy is the way the camera followed me around. Like once I locked it in to the head mode, no matter where I went, the camera followed me around. Now it didn't follow me around like super quick. If I wanted to do super quick, I'd probably have to turn it on and go into the software and put it in sport mode. But in the head mode, if I stand up or if I move around, the camera follows you around pretty good. And since the microphone works within that distance, pretty much wherever you stand, unless you're walking away, it's going to pick you up. At the end of the day, I think for a product that comes to market at right under $200, and like I said, on their website, this is, I think right now, $169, and I'm gonna have a coupon for 30% off of it, so you'll be able to buy it anywhere and get 30% off. With all the features and everything that it has, I think it's a pretty nifty, cool product. Like always, I want your guys' interactions. What do you guys think? Do you think that the OBSBot is a pretty solid product? I think it's pretty cool. Your only limitation is the device that you're hooking into. Obviously, if you're hooking into your Mac or your PC at home, that's probably not gonna be able to move around too much with you, so you'll have to set up in that area. But if you have a laptop, you can take it wherever you go. Also, the software works for both Macs and PCs, so it doesn't matter what kind of computer you have, you can be using the OBSBot in just a few seconds. So I'm Elric, thank you guys for watching Tech of Tomorrow. I hope you guys like this video. I'll have another link down below for this product so you can check it out on their website or check out some other videos about this product out there on the web, but I think it's pretty straightforward. It does 1080p at 30 frames per second. That's pretty much all anybody needs when you're just, you know, doing basic type of stuff in meetings like that. It detects all different lighting conditions, changes them. It'll follow you around. It has different modes that you can use. A decent microphone, it'll mount on a tripod, or it'll mount onto your monitor. It comes with the USB cable and simple to run. So we'll see you guys back here on the channel. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit that like button. And if you like what you see, I'd love to have you subscribe. But if you subscribe, make sure you turn on that notification bell, ding, or you won't know I am making videos. So thank you guys for watching Tech of Tomorrow. Peace, and we'll see you guys back here in the tech world for more tech.